Hi friends, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to see how to make the traditional fish peera. This is a Kerala delicacy which is very easy to make and very tasty. Let's start preparing this dish. To a blender, add 3 green chilies, 1 cup shallots, 1 cup shredded coconut, 2 inch piece ginger, some peeled and washed garlic, 3 dried red chilies, and some curry leaves. Now we are going to grind this into a coarse paste. After grinding, your mixture will look like this. Now transfer it to a vessel. You can also add some water to empty the contents in the blender and add it to the vessel. Now add the sardines that we have into the mixture and rub the mixture all over the fish for the flavors to get incorporated into the fish. This step is effective when done with the hand, but if you don't wish to, you can always use a wooden ladle. After giving it a good mix, cover the vessel and keep it aside for about 15 to 20 minutes. After 20 minutes, take a pan and add 3 tablespoons coconut oil and 3 tablespoons of any other oil of your choice. Here I have used sunflower oil. Add 1/2 a teaspoon of fenugreek seeds and 1/2 a teaspoon of jeera. And add some curry leaves. Now add the fish mixture to the pan and mix it well with the oil. Now add 1 teaspoon turmeric powder to the pan and mix it well. The green chilies, the ginger, the onions and the coconut have already started releasing their flavors. Now add some water to the pan to give it some moisture, just to prevent the fish from sticking to the pan. Now cover the pan with a lid and wait for 5 minutes. After 5 minutes we can see the curry boiling, so give it a good stir. Now add 1 teaspoon salt and add the black tamarind to the pan. Mix it well, cover the pan and cook for about 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, we can see that the gravy has thickened. This is the right consistency for serving it with chapati, dosa and other tiffin items. If you are going to serve it with rice, then you can add more water and make it like a curry. But this consistency is always perfect for me, so I am not adding any extra water. Now give it a good mix so that all the masala gets incorporated with the fish pieces. This is a very easy one pot dish which can be done under 30 minutes. So in case if you have any surprise visitors at home and they like having traditional Kerala items, then this is the dish to go for. It is very very easy and it is very traditional in taste. Now cover the pan and cook for another 5 minutes. After 5 minutes, check the salt and adjust it according to your taste. Now it is perfectly done, so I am switching off the flame. Rest the curry for 10 minutes and then serve. This dish is green in color. It is very light to eat yet flavorful. Hope you enjoy it. Thank you for watching my video. Please give me your feedback about this dish and how it turned out to be. Please like and subscribe to my channel and always continue to give me your love and support. Thank you.